Mark Twain is not just the name of a riverboat or a great American author. It also means the water here is 2 fathoms deep. That means it's safe enough for us to proceed on our steam-powered journey along the rivers of America. On our trip, we'll visit the magnificent Columbia of the Great Northwest, the graceful Missouri of the windswept plains, and the rugged Rio Grande along the border of Texas and Mexico. I'll be sure to point out interesting sights along the way, and even tell you about a legend or two. We begin our trip right here on the mighty Mississippi, heading south and ending up down in New Orleans. New Orleans is rich in history, music, good food, and ghost stories. One of those stories involves the old mansion you see over there on the hill. I've heard it said that the place is haunted, filled with 999 ghosts, ghouls, and goblins. And they're looking for one more to make it an even 1,000. If you're brave enough, you should see for yourself after we arrive back at the landing in Frontierland. We're now passing Bowers Harbor. This is home to the three-masted wind jam of the Columbia, the first American ship to circumnavigate the globe. Here's a bit of history for you. The Columbia set sail for Boston Harbor in 1787. She rounded Cape Horn and became the first American ship to carry the stars and stripes around the world. The famous landmark in this area is Splash Mountain, named for the fact that everyone seems to have a splashing good time when they visit. Splash Mountain is part of Critter Country, a remote wilderness filled with tall vines, rustic buildings, backward bayous, and one of those tall tales we often hear along the river. The story is that the birds and animals that live here can talk, sing, and dance. Like I say, just another tall tale. While you're in Critter Country, you might want to grab a paddle and try your hand at the Explorer canoes. You can work up a real good sweat rowing one of those around the river. Me? I'll take the comfort of the Mark Twain Riverboat any day. As we head into the remote areas of the rivers of America, you're in for a real treat. I've been navigating these parts for years now, but I never get tired of taking in the breathtaking beauty of the Columbia River. The majestic trees, the stunning rock formations, the cascading waterfalls, the moose, deer, and elk along the banks. It's all so magnificent and so peaceful. That means we're all clear as we head up the Missouri River to the home of the Plains Indians.
Thank you.
back into civilization along the Rio Grande. Off in the distance are the towering buttes of Big Thunder Mountain.
That is?
Rumor has it that the railroad built to haul gold out of the mountain has been seized by supernatural forces, and they've turned the mining trains into the wildest ride in the wilderness. Of course, that may be just another legend of the river. Just ahead is the frontier land, where our journey ends. On behalf of our entire crew, I'd like to thank you for booking passage on the Mark Twain Riverboat. At this time, we ask that you prepare to disembark. If you're on one of the upper decks, please make your way down to the first deck. The stairways to the right side and the back of the boat may offer the quickest and easiest route. We hope you enjoyed your voyage with us and that you'll visit us again real soon.
Ready?
Engine room. Approach ready at 1/4 speed. Man for the line. All passengers, stand by to go ashore.